Hey guys, I'm Jordy and welcome to Premiere Basics. Today we'll cover the effects controls panel, or the clip properties like some people call it. Let's fire up Premiere Pro and add a clip into the timeline. Select a clip and then head over to the effects controls panel. If you can't locate it, head over to the menu, window, and from here find effects controls. Now right in here you can find multiple properties of the clip that we can adjust. Under motion, we can find the position, from which you can change the X and Y position of your clip. You can either click and drag on the value to change it, or click on the text to enter a custom number. At all time, you can reset your changes with this button next to the property, and the same goes for all the other properties as well. Next up is the scale. With this property, you can scale your clip to make it smaller or bigger. When you deselect the uniform scale checkbox, you can scale the height and width separately, which gives you kind of a distorted look to your footage. Next, we've got rotation, which lets you rotate your clip both clockwise and counterclockwise. And now comes an interesting one, the anchor point. Now, this is not the same as the position. It's a small cross in the middle of your clip that you can move. Whenever you change a different property, such as the rotation, it will rotate the clip around that anchor point. And the same goes with scaling. Your clip will scale from and to the anchor point position. Next, we've got the anti-flicker effect. And honestly, I think that this doesn't really work that well, but you're always welcome to try it out. Basically, if you increase the filter level, the flickering in your shot, if you have that, will decrease. The one thing to note is that you're also able to select the motion category, which allows you to change lots of these properties visually in the program monitor. Things like scaling, rotation, position, etc. Next up is opacity. By adjusting this percentage, you will make your footage more transparent. Since there's no other clip in a timeline, it will just decrease the brightness. If you stack a clip above another one and then decrease the opacity of the clip, they will kind of blend together. Now, speaking of blending, there's also a blend mode option. This only works when having two clips stacked in a timeline. Again, make sure that you have the top clip selected. Just browse through the different blending modes to create a cool effect. More about this in the dedicated blending mode tutorial video, link in the description or in the card up there. Next up, we can adjust the audio properties of the clip. Now, this will of course only work if your clip has audio attached to it. If it's not linked to your video clip, then you can also select an audio clip and just change those properties from there. Basically, you can adjust the audio volume and pan the audio from left to right. Now keep in mind, guys, that all of these are standard settings for every clip. If you put effects on your clip, they will also be added in this effects controls panel, but that's for a later video. Now make sure to click that first link in the description down below, guys, to join our top-rated Adobe Premiere Pro class for beginners. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, stay creative.